Now, if I'm going to give Rizal a soundtrack to all of his girls, all of his relationship, probably I would play this song to him. So the title of the song would be Forbidden Song number 2. Mandag Pogi Problems by Benny Bunny Band. You can check this out sa YouTube. Pero I'll probably pakita ko lang yung first line kung bakit I decided to choose this song as a soundtrack for Rizal's love life. So you can check this song sa YouTube for the whole song. Wala pang ano eh, wala akong makitang music video for this. Puro ano lang, puro lyric songs. Songs with lyrics. Rizal had a lot of relationship with girls. The first girl that I'll put in this slide is Vicente Ibarda Laza or Miss L. Miss L, why? Because they got this one from the last name of Vicenta Laza, yung letter L. So his father did not like her family primarily because Miss L is older than Rizal. Madalas siyang tinatawag na the professor kaya siya matanda. It did not last because Pepe is still in love with Segunda. So in order for us to easily remember Miss L, L here stands for Lola. Lola, why? Kasi nga medyo matanda na si Vicenta. So try to imagine, Rizal almost had a relationship with an older girl or older lady. Ganun kalakas yung kamandag ni Rizal. That's why I decided to choose the Forbidden Song number 2, which is Kamandag. And the next girl after Vicenta is Leonor Valenzuela from 1877, so 1878. So all of this happened right after Rizal finished his studies with studies in Ateneo. So Leonor Valenzuela is the neighbor of Rizal in Intramuros while Rizal is studying his medicine sa UST. So what significant event took place while Rizal was with Leonor was this one. He wrote love letters with Leonor using an invisible ink. Anong invisible ink? Probably Rizal was using a lemon juice, and then his notes is written dun sa papel, and then the message behind the invisible ink can be seen using heat. So makikita mo yung message ni Rizal dito na invisible using the lemon juice kung if you're going to use a heat. Kundi most likely kandila eh. Kandila, tas makikita mo na yung message. So to easily remember Leonor Valenzuela, tandaan natin yung Valenzuela City na madalas binabaha. Valenzuela City is a city located in the north of Manila, sa SM North, bandang SM North. Bandang northern part ng EDSA, that's Valenzuela. Valenzuela is a city that is more or less binabaha ng madalas. So, ayun yung baha. So, anong kinalaman ng baha dito? Yan yung lemon juice. Lemon juice, liquid. Ayun yung liquid na pag nasa ilalim ka ng baha, magiging invincible ka. Invisible. So, invisibility. The lemon juice is a liquid. Liquid is associated with water. Water, binabaha parate sa Valenzuela. So, Leonor Valenzuela is the neighbor of Pepe while he was studying in UST. Next is Leonor Rivera. Leonor Rivera was a childhood sweetheart of Rizal. So, another Leonor came sa buhay ni Rizal. Leonor Rivera is a distant cousin of Pepe. It's the daughter of a cousin of Pepe's father. So the father of Jose Rizal, the father of Jose Rizal had a cousin, and that cousin has had a daughter, yun si Leonor Rivera. So si Leonor Rivera is the Maria Clara, character of Maria Clara in Rizal's No Limit Angre. The pen name of Leonor Rivera is Taimis. Taimis is a kitchen utensil. madalas ginagamit ito sa siomay to sustain the heat of the siomay itself. So, anong kinilaman ng thymus doon sa thymus na pen na ginamit ni Rizal sa kay Leonor Rivera? Leonor Rivera, his relationship with Leonor Rivera is hidden. So, it's like the siomay that you're keeping inside this kitchen utensil. So, yung vessel na to, kitchen vessel na to, and doon si Leonor Rivera, the relationship is kept hidden because Leonor Rivera was a distant cousin of Pepe. So, it might cause a scandal within the family if a lot of people, if they would reveal the relationship to a lot of people. So, this is Maria Clara. Ito si Maria Clara dun sa novel ni Rizal. Siya yung, he's the girl na kasintahan ni Crisostomo Ibarra. Crisostomo Ibarra was the protagonist in that novel. In the end, the relationship did not go well. So si Ibarra in that novel represents the personality of Jose Rizal. And then Rizal wrote another book entitled To the Philippine Youth. Ito yung medyo kilala nating tula na ginawa ni Rizal. Why? Kasi nandun yung linya na ang kabataan ang pag-asa ng bayan. So this poem was written by Rizal for the youth, kabataan. He wanted that the youth would have a lot of energy and interest in life. Why a lot of energy and interest of life? Because they are the future of our country. He observed that during his time, majority of the youth during his time lacked energy and interest in life. Ang tawag dun is lethargy. Sabi ni Rizal, we have to escape or at least rise the status of being lethargic. Yung katamaran, madalas natutulog na walang ginagawa. Kasi, sabi nga ni Rizal, malaki ang responsibility ng kabataan for nation building. If the youth of today lacks energy and interest in life, in effect, yung bansa natin won't have any future. So it's like describing the wheel of life. What do you mean by the wheel of life? Paikot-ikot lang yung cycle ng obligation ng responsibility for the nation. Right now, you are the youth. And after probably 10 to 15 years, hindi na kayo bata. Ang magiging next in line na would be another generation. So meron tayong Generation X, we have the baby boomers, we have the Generation X, we have the millennials, we have the Generation Z. It's just a cycle. So yung message lang ni Rizal dito is for the youth, yung kabataan, to be conscious of its responsibility for nation building. Nasa palad mo, sabi nga ni Francis Magalona, nasa palad mo ang kapalaran. Ganon din yung message sa kanta niya, kabataan para sa kinabukasan. Another literary piece that Rizal made was The Council of the Gods. The Council of the Gods is a literary piece that he made because he joined a specific contest while he was in UST. So the contest commemorated Cervantes. Cervantes is a literary artist, Spanish yung kanyang nationality. Cervantes author Don Quixote. So it favors the contest by default should favor Spanish students or Spanish individuals who are joining the contest. Pero at the end, so by default nga, dapat ang mag-favor ng contest, dapat mga Spaniards. Pero at the end of the contest, a lot of Spanish judges were surprised that the person who won the contest was an Indio, was a Filipino. Napanalunan ni Rizal yung yung price. So dun sa title na ginawa ni Rizal, The Council of the Gods, nag-meeting yung mga gods. They were discussing who is the deserve person who deserves their merit. Sino ba sa mga literary artists noon na contemporary ni Rizal na ang karapat-dapat na bigyan ng award? Dun sa Council of the Gods sa ginawa ni Rizal, in-award yung highest award kay Cervantes. Yung award na binigay kay Cervantes ng mga Diyos is a laurel. The gods gave merits to literary writers, a lot of literary writers from the past and at the present, but they gave the highest award to Cervantes. Laurel, yung nilalagay sa ulo, laurel represents a superior individual. It represents an individual with the highest intellectual, kaya siya nilalagay sa ulo. So, laurel, ibig sabihin yung pinaka-valuable attribute ng isang tao is the intellect. So, among the literary writers, si Cervantes, according to the Council of the Gods made by Rizal, si Cervantes ang pinakamagaling, pinakamatalino sa lahat ng mga writers. That's why Rizal won that contest. So, Pepe won. This made the Spanish community really mad. Kasi nga, they have this stereotypical attitude that the person or the one who will be joining the contest and who will win the contest should be a Spanish or should be a Spaniard. Because of this, Pepe disproved the Spanish superiority. So parang si Rizal, si David, tapos si Goliath, yung mga other Spanish competitors. So sino ba si Don Quixote? Cervantes authored Don Quixote. So sino si Don Quixote? It's a person who decided to become a knight. Ito siya. So let's check further kung sino si Don Quixote. So originally si Don Quixote, ang name niya is Quijano. So si Quijano loves to read a lot of books. So Quijano reads a lot of love stories that portray knighthood. Knighthood or anything that provides this, the thought of being chivalrous. Merong chivalry dito. Or being a knight or being a gentleman. So it's a love story of being that would portray knighthood or pagiging gentleman. So dito yan, makikita yan dito. So you can only say that someone is gentleman if someone is good with women. So if we can still remember, Spaniards are known to be or to possess at least this attribute, yung pagiging gentleman. Yung sobrang kababasa ni Quijano resulted to losing his mind. So nabaliw si Quijano dahil sobrang basa niya ng mga love stories. Those stories greatly influenced his way of thought. Si Quijano. That's why later on he decided to become a knight and serve his nation. Yung Quijano, binago niya ng Don Quixote. Don Quixote because he knew that serving the nation would upgrade his common status to the upper class status of the society. Kaya may Don. So, ibig sabihin ng Don, from a common person, na itaas siya dun sa middle class or the upper middle class of the society. Then, during his vacation sa UST, ganito ulit, katindi yung kamandag ni Rizal. He went to Pakil. Yung Pakil is located at the upper portion of Laguna, almost katabi ng Rizal. And then, he went to Pagsanhan. Nandito lang yung Kalamba, andito yung Binian. So, andito yung Pagsanhan, andito yung yung Pakil. Now, the question is why? Why would Rizal go to Pakil and then Pagsanhan? It's because andun si Miss L. Si Vicenta Ibar de Laza. Nakipagkita siya dito or nakita niya si Vicenta or si Miss L who was playing skillfully the harp. Ito yung harp. So after naman nito, so isipin nyo, after niya makita yung isang chicks niya, pumunta naman siya dito sa pagsanhan para at least to check Leonor Valenzuela. Leonor Valenzuela, yung neighbor ni Rizal sa UST. Valenzuela, yung pinapadala niya ng messages using the Invincible Ink. So sa pagsanhan din natin makita yung pagsanhan falls. So ganun katindi si Rizal na after niya dun sa isang lugar, dun naman siya sa isang lugar just to check his chicks. And then while Rizal was in UST, dahil nga physically fit si Rizal, medyo he got this from Tio Manny, he got into a lot of fights. May mga rumble siyang, street rumbles siyang sinalian because he founded a society named Companyarismo. Sa secret society, Companyarismo means comradeship. Comradeship or friendship. The members were called Companions of Jehu. Companions of Jehu kasi ang Jehu dito is their leader na si Rizal. So, sino si Jehu? Jehu is a king of Israel. He was a Hebrew general and a king or ruler of Israel. So the reason why Rizal got into a lot of fights because ang kalaban nila parate are the Spanish students. Ang reason dito is racial discrimination pa rin. Ang pinaka-ayaw ni Rizal sa UST is the racial discrimination being expressed by a lot of students to the Filipinos. Same thing applies to the professors as well. Compared to Ateneo, wala siyang naranasan na racial discrimination sa Ateneo. Dito lang sa UST. UST is being supervised by the Dominicans. Katoliko pa rin. Sa Ateneo, Jesuits, Katoliko pa rin. And then because of these bad experiences that Rizal had sa UST, he decided to transfer and continue his medicine sa Spain. So from UST, balak niyang i-continue yung medicine niya sa Spain. For a lot of reasons, ilalagay lang natin dito, 3 reasons. So there are 3 reasons why Rizal decided to transfer to Spain to continue his medicine. First, hostile yung mga Dominican priests and UST professors. When I say hostile, medyo masama yung ugali and aggressive yung ugali nila pagdating sa mga Filipino students. Andun parati yung racism, racial discrimination because they are considered as Indios. Again, Indios, they are inferior students. Andun yung racial discrimination, so connected yung number 1 at saka number 2. And then number 3, obsolete yung mga instruction nila in terms of teaching those students. Obsolete, ibig sabihin, out of date parate. Bakit ko nasabi ito? Because of the most of the laboratory instruments that they're supposed to use in their science courses, they are only for display. So, pakitan tao lang yung pinapakita ng UST sa public. Nandun lang nakikita sa cabinet yung mga apparatus and laboratory instruments. Madalang nila magamit yun for actual studies in a class. Again, may hostile, may racial discrimination, and then obsolete yung instruction. So those are some of the reasons why Rizal decided to continue his studies abroad, sa Spain. So that's the end for chapter 5. Next will be chapter 6, Spain na.